You know, I feel like a lot of people oftentimes just look at me as someone who flip-flopped or blindly hates Xbox, which isn't the case. I'm very thankful to those of you of intelligence who realize that I don't hate Xbox, but rather am just a really ticked-off customer over the past, you know, 3-4 years, and it's kind of all come to a head, and I really want them to succeed. I want them to come out and be the Xbox that I, you know, grew up with, and I think that with this July event, that they're going to offer a lot of things that impress myself and you guys as well, even if you're not a huge Xbox fan. I think that what they have to offer is going to be pretty significant, and it's something that could get people definitely interested back in Xbox again. And that doesn't mean you have to hate PlayStation. I'm just saying they're going to have a good show, and from what I've heard, it's going to be a really good show. What's up, everybody? Crap Gamer here with Crap Gamer Reviews. Back with another video. Thank you so much for checking it out. I really do appreciate it. I would also appreciate it if you guys hit the like button. A simple like on a video can mean the world to someone like me, a small YouTuber, you know what I mean, just looking to kind of gain some traction. It would mean the world. If you really want to support me, hit the bell. If you really, really want to support me, consider becoming a member. You know, those are the best ways you can do it. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you guys so much for continuing to rock out with me. Those that do, you guys are absolutely amazing and much, much appreciated. So, Microsoft is teasing their July event. They already started teasing the event with some Halo Infinite stuff, with the Banished obviously coming back into the play. And I think that, you know, that's a very smart thing to do. A lot of people want to know what's going to be announced. First and foremost, I will say there's things that are probably confirmed that are going to come, and there's things that are more or less, you have to take them with a grain of salt. I always want to make sure to point that out, because people like to kind of shove things back at me and go, oh, well, you promised this or you said this. Keep in mind, you know, I hear things, other people hear things. It doesn't necessarily mean that those things always end up being there. You know, a lot of times it ends up just being a situation where things can change last minute. But from what I've heard, and from what other people have heard, and from what other people have told me, just in general, I have a pretty significant rundown of what you can expect from the showcase in July. And it looks like it's going to be taking place somewhat early in July, since they're already teasing it, and we still have over a week to go in this month alone. So it's going to be very interesting to see where this all lands, and I'm very excited to see where it lands myself, just because it's been so long since we have had anything to really get excited about in terms of Xbox and gameplay and all this kind of stuff. So I'm very happy to kind of talk about this stuff. So again, what are you going to expect from this? Honestly, well, these are the things that I would expect 100%. I would expect Halo Infinite. We know that's going to get a huge showcase. This was going to be the showcase of all showcases for Halo Infinite at E3, but E3 unfortunately was canceled, and so they're going to have to showcase this year. We have seen zero gameplay for this game, right? So zero gameplay, and this game is coming out in November, so they're definitely going to showcase, you know, Halo Infinite. It's their big money game, a full gameplay revealed. Now, from what I've heard, if you ask me, I've heard that there could possibly be a situation where they have a multiplayer beta lined up for that, right? Where they're going to announce that, and there's going to be like a weekend or a week to be able to play the multiplayer and see what that's all about. So we'll have to see if that comes to fruition, but that's definitely something to kind of keep your eye on. You know, also in terms of hardware, either this is where we're going to get introduced to Lockhart, or it's not going to happen, right? Like, I've heard both things. It's a thing, it's not a thing. If it's a thing, then this is where they're going to introduce it to us, right? They can't really afford to hold off, and it wouldn't make sense to hold off any longer than this. So we'll have to see exactly how that goes. Apparently Halo is going to look fantastic, and it's going to be like one of the best looking things we've seen. So I'm really looking forward to seeing that. Obviously, I've 100% confirmed, and I've heard this from multiple people, that Fable is going to be there. Playground Games, obviously doing Fable. A lot of people don't think that, you know, that it's happening, but it is 100% happening. Supposedly, it's going to keep the high fantasy and humor of the originals while supporting a little bit grittier aesthetic. Obviously, this is going to be a huge game, and a lot of people have been waiting a long time for a true Fable game. They're going to showcase the seasons like they did in Forza Horizon 4. Those are going to be like real life seasons in Fable, so I'm very excited for that. Ninja Theory obviously has a couple things that they can show, some Hellblade 2 gameplay. I know supposedly it's going to be built up on Unreal Engine 5, but I would also suspect that they're going to show off a little bit more of that. They also had Project Mara, which was their little side shoot game. There could be something about that as well. I've heard the Initiative's game is going to be there. When I asked further about the Initiative game, whether it be a Perfect Dark reboot, I heard that that's not really the total story there. So I'm not exactly sure if that's going to be something that, if it's Perfect Dark or if it's something else, because I have heard that there's going to be new IP there as well. So we'll have to see sort of how that works. You know what I mean? Like, it wouldn't make sense to not go into any new IP. So in terms of what their first party is going to be doing, I think it's going to be very important for them to kind of showcase something new. Supposedly, Rare has more stuff for Everwild as well. And I think that this is something that, you know, obviously people are going to be happy with or whatever. I don't know. Like, supposedly it's a game, games as a service type thing, you know, so I don't know. We'll have to see what it is. Definitely, Obsidian Entertainment is said to be having something in the AAA realm. If it's ready or not, I don't really know. But the reason that they obviously picked up that team is to make games, and obviously the RPG genre is something that Microsoft has really kind of failed at lately. So obviously, you know, it's going to be interesting to see what's going on. According to this that I was reading, The Outer Worlds was made by Obsidian's B team, and the A team has something completely different in a fantasy game similar to Skyrim. There's going to be the Forza Motorsport 8. It's going to be kind of a reboot situation. You know, here's the thing. We're also going to see some other stuff that maybe that was introduced to us as Xbox One, and since they kind of ended the generations, it wouldn't surprise me to see them maybe launch as, you know, launch games as for the Series X, as well as be playable on the Xbox One and things like that. Like, all their games are going to be for years to come. You know, again, what do I mean by that? Well, again, I think something like Gears Tactics is probably going to launch with that. I think something like Battletoads might be re-mentioned again and could launch. Flight Simulator, something along those lines, could definitely come out and launch with the next Xbox. It makes sense to have a racing game on there. Will all this stuff be ready sooner or later? I don't really know, but these are the things that, you know, I've heard personally, and that makes the most sense to me when you kind of think about it. I still think, you know, you're a couple years out from stuff like Hellblade releasing, but, you know, just seeing some of this stuff, I think, could go a long way in mending some of those issues that people had with, you know, Xbox for, you know, the past 3-4 years, and I really hope to see this stuff. Is that stuff going to be enough to sway you or sway me? It really depends. Like, I want to see, you know, at least 3 to 4 new AAA IP. If you go back to the Xbox One reveal and their first E3 in 2013, they showed off 4 new AAA IP, including Sunset Overdrive, Titanfall, Rise, Son of Rome, and Quantum Break. So they need to show some new IP in there as well. I don't mind them bringing back some of the older stuff. There's rumors that they're bringing back some older stuff. I think that's perfectly fine. Obviously, you want to really talk about, you know, what's really going to be coming, what's really going to be coming up with certain issues and things like that. But I still feel like, you know, we're going to have to see and wait and see a lot of different things from Microsoft. They've got a lot to prove, but I'm definitely interested and seeing what they have to prove. I'm really excited to get next to what they have, you know. And if they announce that you can pre-order and they blow me away, I'll be happy to pre-order. You know, it just really depends on what's going on and what's happening with those games, man. I think the AAA stuff, obviously they're going to show some smaller stuff, and I think that that's going to be pretty cool. You know, at the end of the day, is it going to be enough to sway you? I don't really know. Is it going to be enough to sway me? I don't really know right now. You know, it really just kind of depends. But at the end, I still think that they will have a better showcase. And I've been on record as saying this. Mark it down, screenshot, whatever, save it. I think that their July event will be better than Sony's PlayStation 5 reveal. And the reason why I say that and think that is because 100% they've had 5+ years of basically they packed it in and weren't really doing anything. So they've had over 5 years to get ready for the next generation. There were rumors that they kind of packed it in. A lot of people were assuming that they just didn't have budgets and stuff like that. I don't think it was budgetary stuff. I just think they literally packed it in for the generation about 2015 and, you know, kind of retooled and rebooted for the next generation. So they surely should have multitudes of games to show off, and I'm looking forward to seeing what they have, and it should be a better showing. Am I off the Sony hype train because they'll have a better showing? Absolutely not, because I think that's what competition's all about. So they'll show a great show that was better than Sony's, and then Sony has more stuff to show after Microsoft, and that's what I like to see from these companies. So I would love your guys' thoughts and opinions. What do you expect to see? What's it going to take you to really go out there and want to buy an Xbox Series X? I would love to know. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Rack 'em up. Crep Gamer out. Unscripted.